the wonderful folks who brought us baseball cards now bring us Acne Amy, Slain Wayne, and the rest of what are called the Garbage Pail Kids.
Garbage Pail Kids were part of the kids' counterculture of the 1980s, and a fine tradition of anti-authoritarian stickers and jokes that would be sold with bubble gum for, I think it was a quarter. We were bringing the counterculture to a younger group of children, but of course it was the candy counter.
The Garbage Pail Kids, they were a trading card series released from the Topps Company in 1985 and quickly became one of the largest pop cultural phenomenons of that decade.
It was a very interesting time it came out, you know, in 85. I think it just hit a chord, you know.
They were this shock that came in and just blew up.
And they had a lasting impression on me because here's these paintings I was collecting, like that was the first art I was collecting.
Every kid always loved Atom Bomb.
Nasty Nick.
I loved Roybot.
The first one I ever saw was Dead Ted. Joe Blow.
Fryin' Ryan.
There was something weird about the art that it just kind of gave you a weird feeling, kind of like looking at like an old sideshow, like a banner or something. It's just kind of something you'd never seen before.
The card showcased artwork of these cute pudgy-faced little kids doing really malicious activities.
The Garbage Pail Kids could pretty much show anything.
Like smoking, getting drunk.
Eyeballs get gouged out.
Getting shot up full of bullet holes.
And blood is everywhere.
And there's melting faces. Pretty much everything a little kid would love to see.
There's always that smile they have on their face, like, you know, something terrible's happening, but, you know, I'm still good.
Kids are kids, and I just like to see things that their parents say they shouldn't. The bodily liquids and all the warts and snot. That's all what parents say you shouldn't do, and then you see it there, and that's so exciting.
I hid my Garbage Pail Kids with my Mad magazines under my bed because I thought my parents were going to take them away from me, you know, or think that I was weird or something.
It's the gross versus the cuddly, the sick versus the sweet. It's an all-out battle for the hearts and minds of kids.
Garbage Pail Kids survived even through a lawsuit. Lots of parent groups, outrage.
They banned them. We're not allowed to bring Garbage Pail Kids to school anymore.
If you have them, fine, keep them home. Monday morning, I don't want to see them in school.
I think it was like one of the earliest times there was something presented for kids with that kind of like a soft rated R type material, you know.
There was one where the kid has died, I guess. He was like doing one final vomit up and then it's going through the ghost's mouth and it, I was pretty proud of that concept. That was pretty good.
Garbage Pail Kids were very popular because not only did it make fun of your sister's doll, but it also made your parents a little afraid of you.